Hello guys, once again it's Matt and today we have another video. Thank you all the members, all the Patreons, make sure to subscribe. And here we are with the SU-25 SM-3 guys, which is, I gotta say, one of the best aircraft for CAS in the game. It really, really is amazing. Well, technically not the aircraft itself, it's actually the missile. The KH-38 is probably the best missile out there. Like, seriously, this missile is... like, we have nothing that compares to this thing on range and speed and just overall ability to destroy a target no matter where it hits. Of course, you don't have a lot of missiles, but still. The first game that I was playing here was kind of too aggressive. Later, I tried to be a little bit more, you know, a little bit more safe on using these missiles. But yeah. It has a lot of pros and cons on this aircraft, okay guys? I think you have to realize that. This is kind of a first impression video, but just a gameplay video as well, right? The thing is that this aircraft can be deadly, but it has some cons. So the cons are that, of course, it's slow. Any aircraft that has a lot more energy can be a lot... easier to actually be safe from AA systems, but that's only a thing when you don't have a range on your weapon systems. So it kind of cancels out a pro with a con, as you're going to see in the last match that I will play. Another con that it has, and this is a big one, I think this is the only thing that really, really makes this aircraft not as good as people will think. The actual camera system, the camera on the nose is pretty bad, you know, it doesn't have a lot of, I mean, it does have a lot of range, it does have a pretty alright, you know, resolution, it has thermals, but the thing is the gimbal limits, because it's on the nose and the way that it is, the gimbal limits are really limited, so, yeah, you only have like 20 degrees or something of a gimbal limit to the side, so you really need to be pointing to the target's direction to actually get a kill. When you are using laser-guided ammunition. Of course, you can always use the TV-guided ones, and I will for sure test it out, but I don't know, I don't like TV-guided missiles. I think they are expensive to actually respawn in, and the laser-guided ones are a lot more reliable when getting kills, in my opinion. I just prefer to have the laser-guided ones, but this is more of a personal opinion. Of course, if you take the TV-guided ones, you will be able to not care too much about the gimbal limit because you just point the aircraft to the firing position and then you fire the missile and then you just return, you know, you go back or whatever, you defend yourself, right? But again, I still prefer to use the laser ones, so it has that little con that can be overruled, but still. Another pro that this aircraft has, this has a lot of pros. I mean, it's an SU-25, it's strong. It can take a punch, it has a pretty good dogfight parameter for a CAS aircraft. It can take some very big rockets, so you can destroy targets from very far away. You have R-73s, and you have a MAWL system. Yeah guys, a missile or a missile alert warning system? MAWLs? Is that what it is? I always forget. Anyway, it is basically the automatic flare deployment and the detection of missiles being launched onto you. So, yeah, that helps a lot on defending these aircraft against AA systems. The R-73, of course, always an amazing missile to defend yourself, even against the mighty F-20. So, yeah, and I mean, at the end of the day, the majority of the cons, as I was saying, they can be overlooked if you are smart about how you fly. So if you have patience to climb it out, maintain the distance, the speed is not really a problem. If you use the TV guided ones, or if you have an enough range to actually just use the KH-38 from very far away, it doesn't matter that you are pointing to the target's direction and helping him get the kill, right? You just have to be careful. So if you have the skill, that's my point here. If you have the skill to actually be safe about using this aircraft, it is for sure the most efficient CAS platform that we have in the game. But again, you need to be careful. You need to fly in a certain manner. It's not a very easy aircraft, I would say, to fly, because people love to have the performance, and I think it's the best way of people flying. If you have the performance, you can do basically whatever you want, and that's why people love the F-16 as a CAS platform, the Mirage, or even the MiG-27K or something like that, right? But if you can overlook that and properly be active about how you use your missiles and stuff, you can really put any aircraft to shame in this thing. Of course, it doesn't have a lot of missiles, as I said. I mean, compared to the T variant, it can only take 6. But do you even need more? You know, you don't want to be standing in the battle too long. And normally you will not be able to have time to use all the missiles. So I just think that, for example, using the Vikir is kind of an overshot kind of situation. Here, I got shut down by the AA system. I got greedy and I was too aggressive. And yeah, you will see that this is where this aircraft dies, because it doesn't have performance. You are putting yourself at risk over here. Again, this is the second match, and I had the same troubles. So, for example, here I'm at 13 kilometers, a pretty respectable range, but it is way too close. And I'm pushing through the energy of it and everything. I'm not really being smart. Again, this is my first impressions of the aircraft, so I was trying to be aggressive to see how it would perform, right? So, yeah, I'm trying to maintain the lock there. You can do what I'm doing over here, you know, of just maintaining the lock if you're using the laser-guided ones and turning around and stuff, but it is pretty... It's too aggressive. I mean, if it's a Roland or anything like that, yeah, you will... You can maintain the survivability and be alive, but if it's a Panzer or something a little bit better than a Roland, like an ADAT or something, you're gonna get killed. So don't follow up of this way of playing. I will show in the last game how to play with this aircraft, right? So yeah, again, I'm using the mountains over here to get a little bit of distance. I was honestly already thinking about these missiles have a lot of range. They technically have 40 kilometers of range. So, okay, I can use that range to basically cover me. So, I was thinking 13 kilometers is enough, right? But it really isn't, right? Like 13 kilometers, it might be enough for some AA systems, but not top tier AA systems, right? So, yeah, I went for that target over there. Now I was a little bit more smart about it, so I decided to lower my airspeed. And again, since I'm basically just going towards the target, it's very easy for the AA system to hit me, even at these distances. So yeah, of course, these missiles have INS, so you can still get the kills if the target doesn't change. But here is how you play it. So, started the game, I just fired a missile. I thought that tractor was an AA system, and it wasn't. Which is... No, I'm not gonna say nothing about that word. You get the joke if you know what I'm talking about. But yeah, I saw that those tanks over there, so I was trying to limit my exposition to AA systems, but I wasn't getting anything on the RWR, and yeah, we were pretty far away. Still 14 kilometers of a launch, 9 when it actually landed. But now I'm actually going to be safe about it. I'm going to fly towards the spawn again and get my distance back up. And I'm doing this very like aggressively still. You can do this from a longer range. So I'm at 19 kilometers and yeah, I'm trying to look for targets. And I saw 2 AA systems over there. So I'm at like 19 kilometers and I do the shot. And 19 kilometers, there is almost no possibility of the AA actually getting to you, the missile. Although you need to keep looking at the AA system fast enough, like before your own missile. You can help your aircraft by taking your speed down a little bit. I'm at 400, 500 kilometers per hour, low thrust, you know, and just maintaining the laser. So as you see, I'm at 14 kilometers, which is a very long range. And the missiles are still, like, they're almost hitting the target. And it hit the target at, let's see, like 11 kilometers or something. So 11 kilometers is very, very far away, guys. For most AA systems, they will not be able to hit you. And again, I'm gonna return to the spawn, get a little bit of altitude, get a little bit of speed, and maintain doing that. So again, I just returned at 20 kilometers here. And I mean, a tank that it's at 20 kilometers from me don't even know that a missile is coming towards him. You know, of course, especially this missile. It has way more range. I mean, we are at half the range of this thing. So yeah, it's incredible. Of course, the TV one only has 20 kilometers because of the seeker. But the laser one, you should be able to get a little bit further. Not too much, because the laser seeker needs to be able to hit the target anyway, right? It needs to be strong enough to hit a target that far away. But yeah, again, I mean, I launched at 20 kilometers and I'm pretty slow. I should have been a little bit slower, to be honest. The slower you are, the better. And I'm just waiting. No AA systems. The only AA system is that one. Yeah. 13 kilometers more or less, and he got killed. No AA systems left, and I saw all of these tanks, and of course, now I only have the KH-25s, right? If I'm not mistaken. So I needed to be aggressive about these, or I actually had another missile, a KH-38, but I thought about using the KH-25, because of course, it's like lower range missile, right? So there's no point of wasting a KH-38 from like 5 kilometers, 7 kilometers, right? Use the KH-25 then. And here there was an F-16 in the air and another AAA locking me, so I decided to maintain a little bit of distance. Went cold, dropping some chaff. I saw a missile launch the air, so I was kind of scared of a missile coming towards me, so I just decided to go lower like this. And yeah, guys, keep doing this and you will always be alive. And you will destroy the whole team. Of course, as again, you only have 6 missiles, but I mean, you are on the side of your own airbase. You can just land and get more missiles, right? Eventually, we will lose here, but yeah, it's probably the safest missile or the safest aircraft to do CAS that I ever flown. You know, it's an aircraft that you really can just fly really far away. There are others that can do that for sure, and I will test some of them as well. But I don't know, the SU-25 is just the perfect combination of that. These missiles are amazing. It's more due to the missile than anything else, right? Anyway, I hope you enjoyed. Make sure to subscribe and let me know in the comments what you think about the SU-25 SM3 with the KH-38.